Good day. This is the Pleiadian High Council of Nine. We are here to answer your questions.
Thank you very much for coming through and communicating with us. It is a great honor to have you. We would like to ask a few questions regarding the what we call Medbeds.
Yes.
The vessel that you speak through right now, Erica, she just mentioned that this technology is from your race. Is that so?
Yes. Since we contributed our physical DNA to the humanity in the beginning of the creation of humans, this made a lot of sense for us to provide our technology to you. Even though none of the galactic societies are using this technology any longer, because that's very dense for us, but it is very useful for you to use while you're shifting from 4.8 dimension you're sounding with yourself. It means Earth is 5D, but for some reason, you are not completely assimilating into 5D structure. And this is very important for you to do that. And getting rid of all disease and illness and any kind of unbalanced condition will be helpful to speed up your process. So this device, the technology is useful for you because this is a 4D technology we had in Pleiades. So this is good technology to use for 4D beings after or maybe at beginning of 5D, when you are sort of transferring yourself, your consciousness from upper 4D to lower 5D. Because after you completely shift yourself to 5D and acclimating into that dimension, you do not need assistance from the device any longer.
This is wonderful news. I have a question. I would like to start with this following question. I know as a healer and a hypnotherapist that, excuse me, that imbalances on the human body or mind occur from certain traumas and things that have not been resolved. I wonder how has this been, what is your perspective on that? Because I'm thinking now as you speak, perhaps if someone gets in the med bed and gets completely healed, isn't he bypassing his imbalance and the things he needs to work on?
No, this is more of the physical illness aspect. So yes, this person will lift the vibration up more than the usual state. But you have to think of the Earth is vibrating 5D already. In normal condition, humans should be vibrating in 5D as well. Some people are still vibrating in 3D because of their illness, because of their fear. And this is we consider as artificial intrusion. This is not a natural process. Because when the ascension happens, the planet itself will raise the vibration and all of the legend within that planet will follow. So plants and animals are already 5D and humans are only species vibrating less than 5D. And you could think of the various factors why they aren't. Some of the people who are more of spiritually awakened, you are vibrating 4.8D, who are listening to this transmission, or Erica's, However, other people who aren't, they are vibrating much lower frequencies. Could be 3D. And a lot of the reason why can come from the disease which was manufactured on purpose. So people can stay in 3D world, whether the planet will ascend or not.
Which one you mean, COVID?
We're not talking about just particular disease. It can be any disease.
I see. But I want to go back to the question I asked you, because I think I didn't, or you didn't understand my question, or I didn't understand your answer. So I would like to ask you perhaps in a different way. And that is like, what happens to the lessons that need to be learned from the imbalances that human beings have? For example, if they get healed from the medbeds, instantaneously, what about the lessons that have not been resolved?
Lesson doesn't have to be learned from having disease. When people are almost dying right now or having incurable disease, don't you think they learned enough? Or when the planet is already shifted to 5D, why do they continue to learn this lesson, which seems to be never ending? Don't you feel that artificial?
So you mean that in some cases it's beneficial, it's part of their natural evolution and process?
It's not a natural evolution, because once everything is shifting, everything within itself should shift as well. And the current structure of Earth, people are struggling to be in the flow of the natural evolution.
Mm.
Because this is not a natural structure where you have placed on yourselves. It's an artificial matrix.
I see what you mean now. Okay. I think you answered my question. Thank you very much. So you said that you have already given this technology on Earth.
Yes, we gifted this technology in 1950s, mm-hmm. hoping this will come out to the public.
I see.
General public. Mm-hmm. It didn't. And you have an opportunity to receive this gift finally now.
So in back in the 1950s, it stayed hidden.
Yes.
Okay. Could you specify where, to which group was this technology being given?
We're not going to the details of it, because the ascension, you have to remember, is not about good versus evil. When you go into the trap of that path, it will be very difficult for all of you to ascend.
Yes,
it is very important to focus on the present. Now, everything is cleared, and you will have opportunity to enjoy this gift finally.
Okay, so do you have a timeline for this?
You have to understand each of you are on your own timelines. So some of the timeline will intertwine or intersect, so you call as a collective timeline, but you individually create your own timeline. So predicting when will be foolish, because that will be 7 billion different timelines.
Okay, for sure. Yeah, I was just more wondering about a group timeline.
Yes, so we will suggest to focus on your joy, happiness, and compassion. Also, if you can do this, Christ consciousness to forgive others who you think they don't deserve to be forgiven.
Mm. Including the quote-unquote bad guys on
yes.
the planet.
Because yeah. the ascension is a choice of all of you decide to ascend.
Mm.
Not selected few or majority of good guys. Anyone who choose to ascend, regardless of species,
mm-hmm.
you can ascend because you are all legitimate in this planet,
mm-hmm.
and that is open path for all. And some of you decided not to ascend for whatever the reason, you will be given to the opportunity to incarnate to other 3D planets, but that is according to your choice.
Yeah, wonderful. Can we talk a little bit more about the Medbeds in terms of their technology? What technology are they using? If there's anything that could be understood by the level of consciousness that we have right now.
Yes, Medbed is, if we put it in a very easy manner for you to understand, without any kind of medical background, Medbed will awaken your DNA. Means your current DNA depends on what we or you vibrate. The strand of DNA will be different. Some of you will only having two strands. Some of you who are in the awakening and have been awakened can having three strands right now, or new children are having four, could be five. It'll be different in different generations and different light quadrant you're having in your body. It'll be different from generation to generations. Newer generation of children, they are having more of galactic characteristics than their grandparents. So easier for them to awaken now, or they are already awakened. So Medbed wake up all of these strand to 12.
Wow.
And by doing that, you will do your own treatment on your body.
You so, mean it? You mean it triggers the self healing?
Yes.
Mm.
That's what it is.
Yes. Yes.
So when you have this junk DNA, so you call junk DNA, within that DNA, you have a lot of galactic DNAs. So when you have galactic DNAs, especially the one from higher frequency galactics, such as us Pleiadians, when those DNA is awakened, when the original prototype of the humans are created, they had the 5D Pleiadian vessel, and you still have that DNA. That means as a 5D being, you know how to imbalance your physical body, keep it in high vibrational level. So when you are bring back your physical vibrational balance, it is impossible for you to stay in having disease. You will be restored yourself back into your original creation. Of course, depends on what kind of the genetic mix-up each of you are having, it'll be different. Some of you still need to acquire your meat because you have more reptilian DNAs. This is what you want to understand. Physical characteristics doesn't mean anything to do with your consciousness level of vibrations. It's just a vessel. And you chose to born into a particular bloodline to serve So let's say if you come from our planet to volunteer to be the member of you, and you get into the bloodline of heavy condensed reptilian bloodlines.
When you mean volunteer, you mean incarnate?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
And then you have heavy body energetically, but your consciousness is very high. So in that case, let's say the person is having disease because the fear, I'm not saying because of the Pleiadian and the reptilian characteristics, the combination. I'm saying when you are having a very heavy, dense body and surrounded by very dense programming of fear, anger, stress, all sort of things, it is easy for you to push the button to open up your possible hereditary disease. And because of everything is energy, all of disease, why this happens. Yes, you have those codes in your body, but whether this will happen or not is because of the vibration, because of your programming, because of the body. And once you go in to Medbed and you will wake up all of your strands of DNAs, it will be balanced. And regardless of your ingredient of DNAs, doesn't matter what concentration it will be, everything is restored in the highest level. And that's what is going to happen. So every single one of you are having Pleiadian DNAs. That doesn't mean you have to have blonde hair and blue eyes. This mingling between the first prototype of humans and others means other prototypes illegally created by people who decided to come in this planet without any kind of permission or invitation. That happened, and the people mixed with each other a long time ago. Could be once, could be twice, could be many times, it doesn't matter. The point is all of you are mixed. This is why you have a mind and a heart. Because the original prototype didn't have a mind. That was Pleiadian, that was not the Pleiadian prototype. We're heart-centered. And the reptilian prototype means human-looking people just like you, but use mind a lot. That mind part was so you call reptilian brain, was created by the idea, let's put our part in this human body.
That was another experiment then.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So this was allowed. So eventually all of you will be mixed and representing a lot of galactic DNAs, which is impossible in regular circumstances among other galactics.
So Earth is like a zoo.
Yes. My it's God. A library of genetics.
Yes. Wow. I want to make a comment on what you were saying earlier, because it blew my mind as you said that what the healing occurs by just activating the DNA and triggering then self-healing. Because that's exactly what happened in my latest quantum healing session I had. My client was escorted by two extraterrestrial beings who didn't want to disclose their origin, and they took her into a ship and then activated her DNA, and this triggered healing on all levels on her. And I'm amazed because this is exactly the concept you are talking about.
Yes. So this Medbed is a little more dense version of it. This is for 4D beings.
Mm-hmm.
Because this is different from, let's say, you use example of you and Erica. You are here on Earth, and when you're sleeping, you go back to Ashton's ship, and then you go into the medical pod. Depends on what kind of the situation you encounter, so you can bring yourself back into balance every day. And that is more of for the higher frequency beings, because it is important for you to remember who you are without getting lost into humanness. Does it make sense?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So that is more of the balancing the frequencies, less of the balancing of the physical characteristics of the body. Because you are borrowing this human body as rental vessel. You have your own body in the ship, and your consciousness is not humans. So it is very important for you to keep that level. You may go up and down just like other humans, but the core of the selfness cannot be lost. This is what you and Erica will do every night when, let's say, you encounter very heavy energetic influences.
Mm-hmm.
Besides having briefing in the ship while you're sleeping.
So now I understand. Thank you for sharing this. That's this private information. It's really amazing. And now I understand why one day I woke up. I remember it was what happened many years ago, but it was shocking, so I still remember it. I woke up and I said to myself, I woke up during the night actually, and I stood up and I said, people think I'm human, and I was giggling and laughing. And then
yes.
I couldn't believe what I said.
Because you have to remember, 5D is still very dense for both of you. And you're at 4.8, very dense. So you need to have your balancing.
Is this happening to many starseeds?
Yes. So some of the starseeds go back to their own ships or their own planets to do this procedure so they can bring back themselves to themselves.
During the night, you mean?
Yes, after the awakening.
Yeah.
That doesn't mean people can bypass their lessons. It is very important for them to go through the lessons and their learning and understanding so they can understand how to lead others.
Mm.
Or how to relate with others.
Yeah.
Part of the reason why you are having human vessel, because you can just land in here with your own body and start teachings, then no humans will understand. They can sort of understand with their brain, but they won't understand in the deep level because they are very different.
Yeah.
And you don't want those people to start worshiping you like humans did in the ancient times.
Yes, exactly. I know. I had an incarnation back then, and I'm amazed by what you say, because exactly that's why I decided to come in this life incognito, like to blend in with other people. I would like to ask you about the technology that is being used for the medbeds. I wonder if it is light.
Yes, it is. So this technology is similar to crystal technologies. It's a predecessor of the crystal technology. So basically, it's a light technology to bring you back into the balance. So when you have a balanced body, balanced mind, balanced emotions, you are healthy. Even let's say some of you are having a fairly healthy physical body and a fairly balanced emotional state, but you do know you still go through emotional up and downs or challenges in staying earth life.
Right,
so just because you have made bed and fixed your conditions, that doesn't mean everything will be going away. You still might have to go through some of the lessons or things if that is what you are required or decided to do. And that's what is happening.
Okay. How are these medbeds going to be rolled out? I mean, how are people going to find them? Because I guess they won't be in the mainstream media, are they?
Yes, the first people in the know will get the information. So those people are already having their own contract. So they'll happen to find the information through a particular group.
You mean soul contract?
Yes.
Okay.
So by experiencing this information and decided to participate, they themselves can spread the information to the mass through their social media or, yes, because since everyone of you are doing social media thing, you can easily to share.
Okay, and are they eventually going to become available for the mass?
Yes.
Okay.
So that is also depends on the what kind of timeline each of you will thread into. Mm-hmm. So some of your timeline will be okay, it will be readily accepted to the huge mass of the regular public, because the collective level you have created within your timeline is very high as the collective. Then that's what you will be going to experience. If some of you are thinking, okay, this will take a long time, the people are not ready to believe in this, blah, 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 you're creating this. So that's what you will exactly experience. So this is why we are, means not just us, Ashtars or Acturians. And we are suggesting do not look into those other people's information, which do not make you feel excited and happy, because you're tapping into that vibration and creating your vibrational reality through other people's ingredients.
Wonderful. And as you speak, I'm being distracted almost because, as you were saying all these amazing, beautiful words, a ladybug just came and sit on my palm.
Yes.
Okay. Do you have any comment on this?
Well, the animals are very in tune with the vibrations. They understand.
Yeah, they sense much more than, because they also don't have the reptilian brain, right? They are more intuitive.
Yes, they are very heart oriented, and they stay in just the present. They don't think about future. They don't think about past.
Yeah.
They don't think about what's if.
Okay, so I would like to ask if there's any question that you might want to bring through from Erica's perspective, because she also wanted us very much that we do this transmission today. If you can tap into her own mind and see if there's anything that perhaps she would like to know today.
Yes, she's asking about the inconsistency of the one party and another party, or parties. Depends on which group you or groups you're belonging to, the information will be varies. So in that case, what do you trust? We would say trust information within. You are more than welcome to listen to outside information. And then after you saturate enough information within yourself, you can ask, what do I think? And you can tap into your knowledge, because you are the one who is creating your reality, hologram, timelines. Or we would say you're shifting into the timelines you have been already created within. So that is our answer.
Wonderful.
And yes, she'll get made a bet. Just asking, am I going to?
Yeah.
And you too, Hara, if you like.
Amazing. Yeah, why not? I don't have any illnesses or so, but I would not say no, activating a few more strands of my DNA, for sure.
Or people can use for vanity purpose. Some people have allergies or want to change your hair color or eye color or lose weight. You can do that.
Okay. What else is possible?
Any kind of physical transformation is possible.
Wow.
Or any kind of nerve transformation. Means, let's say, some of your psychological problem coming from the nerve or coming from the based on the genetical cause.
Will it affect also in, I mean, positively, severe mental illnesses like schizophrenia? And
well, schizophrenia or narcissism would be different. Because some people, they might be tapping into completely different dimensions.
Yes, I know that.
Or some people are tapping into completely different frequencies, which coming from their soul level. And Medbed is not there to fix their soul progress.
Yeah, I see. Yeah, I'm amazed that you bring this information through. It confirms what I have received from my hypnosis sessions. People with schizophrenia, they were just tapping into other parallel timelines, other versions of themselves, and so on.
Yes.
Thank you for this incredible information. I would like to allow you, if there's any last message that you have for us regarding on this topic or anything else you think is appropriate.
Well, we would again to suggest to focus within yourself. This is not burying your head into the sand, because you have to be responsible as a creator what you are creating or contributing for the creation. And depends on what you create and what you put yourself in, you will shift into different timelines. So be mindful of what you are exposing yourself to. And you don't have to believe in others every single word. Always ask, what do you think?
Yeah.
That is our message.
Yeah, yeah.
This is Pleiadian High Council of Nine. We are pleasure to speak with all of you.